Yo, YouTube, it's Elliot from Neanderthal Fitness, www.neanderthalfit.com, personal trainer, fitness instructor, and YouTube fitness talker. So today's video is entirely off the cuff. I say that most days because I don't think about things in advance, but when I say off the cuff, I thought of an idea to make a video about, picked up the video camera, took a swig of water, and changed my mind about what to make the video about. So, you already know because you've read the title, but so I know, and you know more. This video is about what's it like to be a personal trainer. Should you do it? If you want to do it, obviously. What's it like if you do it? What routes can you take? How can you get involved? Alright, so let's talk about this. Okay, so first things first, do you want to be a personal trainer? Now the answer to that is maybe yes, or it may be no. If you've searched for this video, it's probably yes. If you found this video because you're one of my subscribers, it may well be no. So that answers that question. Do you want to be a personal trainer? Okay, let's think about this. The reason you probably want to be a personal trainer is likely the same reason I wanted to be a personal trainer, and most of the other guys who I work with at the gym where I work wanted to be personal trainers. Because we enjoy exercise, we enjoy going to the gym, we're good at what we do at the gym, like we have good form and we know what we're doing with exercises. You probably look at other people in the gym and think, what the fuck are you doing? And then you think, hey, how good would it be and how great would my physique be if I could spend 5 days a week in the gym or 7 days a week in the gym and I didn't have to go to the office, so between clients I could train. And let's face it, the other reason you probably want to be a PT is, there's probably two other reasons. If you're a guy, you want to meet hot women in yoga pants. Let's not deny it. It is one of the, you know, the great things about being a personal trainer. Everyone thinks of a personal trainer as kind of a male slut. I know there are female personal trainers. There are some very good personal trainers. And I'm sure some female personal trainers sleep with their male clients. But realistically, when you see a male personal trainer, they tend to be in good shape, they tend to have perfectly coiffed hair because they're in the public eye all the time, and as a result, they flirt with attractive women because, hey, they have an excuse to talk to them, so why wouldn't you? And generally, jealous guys who have office jobs and don't get to talk to hot women, and women who have maybe been played or get the impression they're going to be played or whatever, a lot of people have the assumption that many male PTs just sleep with loads of their clients. Now, I can honestly say I do not do that. However, you know, the opportunity will likely arise. For most people, it does. And I think that's a one reason, and not necessarily a bad reason to want to be a personal trainer, is the ability to talk to hot women. Alright, that's fine. We'll leave it there. And the other reason is that you've probably seen some of the advertisements by places like Future Fit and Premier Training who say, it's so easy, you could earn 50 grand a year and you get to wear joggers to work and you don't really have to do anything. So those are probably the reasons, right? Okay, fair enough. Now let me talk to you briefly about reasons you might not want to be a personal trainer. So if those are the reasons you want to be a PT, think about these before you make the leap. One. There is no fucking way that it is easy to make 50 grand unless, I will put a disclaimer in here, if you either A, live in a very high-end place, so say you live in London if you're in the UK, or in Miami or wherever, some of the big places where there are a lot of rich people live, or the general cost of living is a lot higher, so you'll charge more per session and you might make 50 grand, but it's not going to be worth what 50 grand would be worth elsewhere in the UK. Or, you know, 80 grand US dollars and not worth what that is somewhere else. Okay, and the other way is if you're a brilliant salesman. So if you used to work in a mobile phone shop or you worked on the telephone selling insulation or something, then you are one step ahead of everyone else because 90% of people who become a PT know what they're doing in a gym and know how to train someone effectively from doing it for themselves and maybe for their friends before they even get qualified. So nobody is going to struggle with training, or very few people will struggle with actually training people. What most of us struggle with is selling. And if you can't sell, if you can't make people see the value of your products, you're not going to make a shitload of money. And to be making 50 grand is frankly, I would say, unrealistic to be doing in your first year, probably for most people, even in your second, third, or fourth year. You may get there, and you might get there in your first 6 months, who knows, but most people don't, because the majority of trainers will charge about £30 an hour for a session. Now, if you work 30, I think I worked this out correctly a while ago, if you work 30 hours a week for £30 an hour, and you take 4 weeks holiday off in a year, so that's assuming you can keep 30 hours of clients every week at full price, I might add, you would earn about 54 grand pre-tax. Alright, now let's look at that realistically. In January you might do 30 hours, and in September you might do 30 hours, because those tend to be the two busiest weeks, or two busiest months in the UK gym industry. But in June, in July, when half your people are on holiday or they're off because they have to look after their kids because they're not there over the 6 weeks holiday, or frankly people don't want to come to the gym because they want to be sat chugging pints in the beer garden because it's sunny outside, you're very unlikely to be working 30 hours a week through that period of time before you're established. I'm not saying that you can't get there. I definitely hope to get there one day, and once you've been doing it for a couple of years, you'll have enough of a client base and people waiting in the wings that you probably can. But for your first couple of years, you are not going to be making 20 grand. You're probably going to be making between, if you work hard at it, between 12 and 17, 18 grand in your first year. And then, you know, if you keep hammer and nail all the way through, that will go up and up and up. So, the money's not as good as everyone says, basically. You have to work a damn lot of hours and get a lot of clients at good rates to make that money. Oh, yeah, that's what I just said as well about full price, is most PTs will say it's £30 for a session, but if you buy 10 sessions or if you buy 20 sessions, it's £25 or £22.50. Therefore, you might be doing 30 hours but not charging £30 an hour, and therefore you still won't make that same amount of money. So, the money is not as good and as easy as people think, so that's one reason to not do it. If you are just in it to pick up chicks, then maybe just do it as a temporary job, because if you're not serious about it and you don't want to put in the time, then realistically, you know, if you're, basically what I'm trying to say is, if you sleep with a lot of your clients, they are not going to be good ongoing clients. You're going to fuck your business up. You're not going to make a lot of money, so you're going to need a backup plan. And the third and the final reason you might not want to be a PT is that hours suck, man. It's split shift working for 99% of us. I know one PT at the gym where I work, he's been doing it for so long now, like 4 or 5 years, that he's really good, he's really well established, and people will train when he tells them to train. So he comes in 5 a.m. in the morning, works till midday, and he has the rest of the day off. Fine, that works for him, but for most PTs, when you first start, you don't have that reputation. If you won't train them when they want to be trained, they will find someone else who will. You know, the only reason they're coming to you probably is because you've approached them, or because they've seen your poster or something, but there will be venues they can take to get to another PT, or avenues they can take rather, and they will do that. So what I'm saying is, you will end up training people probably between 5 a.m. and 8 a.m. because that's before people, majority of people, 9 to 5 workers go to work, and then you'll have maybe 1 or 2 hours in the day with like the pushchair patrol, you know, the mums and buggers kind of people, who don't have jobs but do have well paid husbands. Then, you know, you might have 1 or 2 of those, but for the majority of people you won't work through the day, and then come 5 p.m, 5:30, you will work through until about 9 p.m, 10 p.m. to fit in all the clients, especially if you want to do those 30 hours, assuming you can't train in the day because people have to have jobs to pay for your services. Then you will end up working wee hours of the, like, getting up really early to work until most people would go to work, then you get the rest of the day off to do your errands, do whatever you want to do, and then you will work through until quite late in the night to make up those hours, and therefore you will end up probably not seeing people who work normal hours unless you're training them, so your social life will take a battering, and your relationship may take a battering. You know, if you live with a partner and one of you works 9 to 5 and the other one works 5 till 10 p.m., you don't see each other very often. And that is a negative, you know. Some people like to have their weekends, some people like to have a certain set hours that they do it, and you won't get that as a PT, at least not for your first couple of years, realistically, because what we have to do, guys, is be realistic. So realistically, you won't get that. But okay, enough scaremongering. You've decided you want to be a PT, you think, fuck what that clown on YouTube says, he doesn't know what he's talking about, I could make 50 grand in my first couple of months. Fair play to you, if you want to do it, do it. So okay, how do you go about it in the UK? You need to be qualified to work in most gyms to reps level 3, the Register of Exercise Professionals. Now the bad thing about reps is most people have never heard about it unless they want to be a PT. So although it sounds cool that you pay to join the register once you're qualified and anyone can check your details to make sure that you meet this certain criteria, nobody who's going to train with you will ever have heard of reps, so they'll never check your details. So it's kind of a waste of money, but most gyms in the UK won't let you work there unless you're qualified to that level. That being said, there is no real governing body over personal training in the United Kingdom and in most countries, from what I understand, meaning you do not have to have any qualifications to become a PT. If you're going to work in the parks and fields, or if you're going to open your own gym, you don't need to have any qualifications, but it damn well helps, because I think a lot of people will be like, well, where did you get qualified? Have you got a degree? Have you got this? Have you got that? And if you say, well, actually, I just worked out a lot, so then I opened a gym, people might not want to train with you. They might not think it's safe. So the route to take if you're in the UK is, if you're young, if you're still at school, then do GCSE PE, then do A-level PE, then go to university and do something like a sports science degree, or they do a couple of different ones. They do sports science, they do sports and something else, not sports science. There are a couple of different things that involve sports, basically. And most of those will give you, as an optional extra while you're doing the degree, the chance to do reps level 2 and reps level 3. Level 2 is going to be either your fitness instructor or exercise to music instructor. Level 3 is going to be where you get your personal training qualification. You can also become a yoga, Pilates, or other kind of coach through at level 3. But you need the personal trainer level 3 modules to allow you to work for most gyms. And when I say most gyms, I mean DW Sports Fitness, it used to be JJB, I mean Virgin Active, I mean, those are the only two I know, actually. But any major chains, so probably like Ballantyne's, I don't actually know, but I suspect Ballantyne's you would have to be. Most gyms, especially chains, will all require you to be a member of that. If you are older, you can totally do those courses just as short courses, and I would suggest you go to your local college or university, study a level 2, pass that, and study a level 3. Sometimes they do a discount if you buy the two together. The reason I say to do that is I spent £1,500 doing my level 2 and level 3 together, qualified, ready to go. If you go to one of the companies like Premier Training, or what are the other ones? I can't think of any of the other names. Premier Training is one of them. Oh, the Training Room is another. Anyone that advertises and says you could earn 50 grand, train with us, they will charge you anywhere between 3 to 7 grand to do what I did for £1,500. There's no point. The only thing they give you is interviews with big gyms, and realistically, most PTs are self-employed, so the interview process is not that difficult. You go in and you say, yeah, I can earn this amount of money, and they will give you a job, because you'll be making them money and they don't have to pay you shit. That's one other thing to mention is, of course, once you get qualified, is what do you do in terms of where do you work? Okay, so you can go work in a big box gym. As I say, you'll need to be reps level 3 registered. Most of these gyms charge you rent, which could be £300 to £600 a month, depending on the area, could even be higher. So that's money that you pay to them for the right to train in their gym. So assuming you charge £30 an hour and your rent is £300, you have to work 10 hours that month before you start to take anything home. That is just pocket money for the gym. Alright, so that's something to think about right there. Further to that, is you could go and work on your own. So you could either rent a small premise, put some equipment in. Obviously, you've got the overheads of doing that, or you could get some equipment and go train in a park or in the fields or outdoors. And what's the big major difference? Well, one, if you train outdoors or on your own premises, you take 100% of those profits and you run with them. You don't owe that to anybody apart from the tax man, obviously. Please declare your tax. So, yes, that's one thing you can do. If you work in a big box gym, you owe them money. You're owned by them. Ultimately, you can't normally brand things as your own fitness. You'll just be a Virgin Active personal trainer or a DW personal trainer. One of loads in the barrel. Some people make fantastic money that way. So you might be thinking at this point, well, what's the benefit to working in a gym? The benefit is a pool of members who all want to get fit. So when you go into that gym, you know everyone there is there for the same reason. They want to get fit, they want to look fit, they want to perform better, and therefore each and every one of them is ripe for the picking of being a personal training client. Now, if you don't have a premise, you have to do a lot more marketing. Like, you have to flyer, you have to send stuff out on social media, you have to... Hell, you have to go and talk to people in the street. Like, you see someone who's a bit overweight and then strike up a conversation, just like you're trying to hit on them or something, and then move it along to point out that you're a personal trainer, give them your card, whatever. So finding clients is a lot harder if you're on your own, unless you have a reputation you've built in a gym. So most people start in a gym and then will go freelance in the future. So those are kind of your two options of where you can do. And I guess finally is just to talk about what's it like to be a personal trainer. Realistically, I hate selling. I'm terrible at selling, and the thought of going up to people and striking up a conversation with the sole intention of then ultimately trying to sell them my services makes me feel like a hooker. I don't enjoy doing it, I'm not confident doing it, and I don't enjoy that aspect of the job. That being said, when I am training, when I'm with clients, especially clients that I care about, it's fucking fantastic. Best job in the world, honest opinion. You're working with people, you don't really have to do much for an hour. You come up with this fantastic workout program for them to do, and then you say things like, that's it, keep going, one more, two more, whatever, you know? It's just being encouraging, it's just helping them, checking their form, making sure they're doing things right. You get to chat to people, you get to pass on your knowledge about something you're passionate about, so you get to, you know... You're probably the guy, if you want to be a personal trainer, who talks about fitness and what you've been doing in the gym all the time, and everyone's fucking bored and sick of hearing it from you. And finally, you've got a willing audience. All of your clients are people who want to learn and want to hear about fitness, and you can pass on that mantle. You can show them why you're so passionate about it, get them fired up to work out too. It is honestly the best feeling. You're helping people, you're getting paid quite handsomely per hour, and, you know, nothing beats it that I've ever done, honestly, hands down. So for all the negatives, I do love the profession. But, you know, that's a bit of an insight. That is what it is like to be a personal trainer. That is how you become a personal trainer in the UK. I'm sorry, guys, I don't know about other countries, but realistically, you know, it's going to be something similar. There will be a body that you have to reach a certain level of. People will have probably never heard of it because it's not really controlled by the government, and you'll have to pay X amount to do that course, but it's probably going to be cheaper through universities than through independent companies. So get your qualifications, you know, and get ready, rock out, go be the best personal trainer you can be, and come back and tell me I'm wrong, tell me you're earning 70 grand a year, and if you are, tell me how you did it, because I want a slice of that pie, friends. So thanks for watching, see you in the next video.